Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where we talk about skincare, grooming, sometimes hair, so if that sounds like your thing, make sure you are subscribed. Also come and follow me on Instagram where I post a lot of stuff that you're not gonna see here on YouTube. And also my James Welsh Daily Glow Starter Kit is available still on Wish Trend. A kit filled with everything you need in a skincare routine to have you on your way to glowing skin. I'll link all that in the description box down below. The other day I was doing my routine and using a few new products. And I was thinking about all the things I used to do and all the mistakes that I made and things that I still do. Today I thought I'd share four ways that you could be potentially destroying your skin. Destroying is a strong word, but two of these I think really have the potential to just melt your face off. No, not that bad. It's not that bad. And this video really was inspired by the first point I'm going to talk about, and I need to talk about this now and get it out of the way. But the first thing that you could be doing that could be destroying your skin is following YouTube DIY skincare hacks. I know this is heavily discussed already on YouTube, so I'm going to keep this one short, but I've had an influx recently of people recommending using lemon juice on their face, or asking me if lemon juice is okay on the face, or even just how to use lemon juice on the face. You don't. That's how you use it, you don't. But then there's things like baking powder. There's those DIY glue and charcoal peel-off masks. Toothpaste spot treatments, you know, all things that have no business whatsoever on your face. So lemon juice is highly acidic. And yes, whilst it's gonna temporarily remove those dark spots, it can cause long-term damage to your skin, eventually, if not immediately. The damage that you can see immediately is like an instant acid burn, drying of the skin. The more long-term effects is permanent hyperpigmentation, dark spots that you can't get rid of. You've literally bleached your skin, so your skin is gonna be super sensitive to the sun as well. Yes, as I mentioned, it can cause a chemical burn. Yes, lemon is natural, but it's also a chemical, it's also acidic, and it can burn your skin. If you live in a country that's constantly sunny and you're putting lemon on your skin and you've been doing it for a long time, you do get actual skincare with lemon and baking powder integrated into it, but these have been formulated to work with your skin and be safe on the skin as well. It's also not very cost effective, and the actual effectiveness of the lemon juice is not that good anyway. Like, it's not great. You're much better off buying a serum targeted at hyperpigmentation. You're going to be saving money, it's actually safe for your skin, and it's actually going to work. Very heavily related, the second thing that could potentially destroy your skin is using natural ingredients or opting for products with natural ingredients in because you believe they're better than synthetic/man-made ingredients. You should try more natural skincare. You're putting too many chemicals on your face is comments I get all the time on a daily basis. So a lot of people are shocked when they find out that I much rather use a product with parabens in than a product that claims to be 100% natural. And this is because there's this idea that natural is safer and better, when in fact, some of the most natural ingredients and some of the most natural things out there are some of the most harmful things that you could put on your skin or even ingest. Citrus-derived ingredients, menthol, mint, peppermint, grapefruit, lemongrass, lavender, orange, papaya, witch hazel, eucalyptus, chamomile, sandalwood oil, and even rose oil are known irritants that are all heavily used in natural products or products that contain natural ingredients. Yet people still don't make that connection that natural isn't always safer or better. And that's not saying that synthetic or man-made ingredients or lab-made even ingredients are better. The point here isn't to avoid all natural skincare. That's not what I'm saying. The point is that just like lab-made ingredients, you could have an equally, if not worse, reaction to a natural ingredient. A lot of people refer to like lab-made, is that the right term? Lab-made ingredients, man-made ingredients as chemicals, everything's a chemical, toxic, you know, like they're gonna enter your skin and fill you with poison. Realistically, they're more trustworthy and stable and predictable than natural ingredients. We know exactly how they're gonna react in our skin. In fact, there's a brand that I use, Cioris, I think they're called, that only pick fruit at a certain time of the year because the rest of the year, it's not good to put on your skin. And I feel like this idea has been amplified by the huge fear-mongering and misinformation applications surrounding things like parabens, sulfates, alcohols, and even silicones. So yeah, don't think just because a product is 100% natural or you've literally just picked ingredients off a tree that it's gonna perform miracles on your skin or that it's not gonna do any damage to your skin. So here's an odd one, but the third point I wanna talk about is not mixing ingredients together because you've been told they shouldn't be mixed together when actually they're really good to mix together. We know mixing the wrong ingredients together can destroy your skin. In fact, it's kind of like a YouTube video trend at the moment. You know, the top ingredients you should never mix together. There's articles online everywhere about this, and this is due to the rise of active ingredients. And of course, these ingredients are amazing. You know, they are life-changing, skin-changing ingredients that I wish I had available, as readily available to me in my early 20s and teens as we do now. These are good videos and good articles, but they're also usually backed up by a lot of misinformation and backed up by irrelevant studies. So whilst you could be potentially destroying your skin mixing ingredients together that shouldn't mix together, you could also be missing out on an amazing combination. My personal favorite ingredients that you should never mix together, which I love mixing together, is niacinamide and vitamin C. So there's a general idea that you shouldn't mix these together because one, they kind of like counteract each other and neutralize the effectiveness of each ingredient. And number two, it might create a substance called nicotinic acid or nicotinic acid, I'll write it here, that basically leads to redness and irritation on the skin. But the truth is actually they're a real powerhouse couple that can really brighten and even out your skin tone. This comes from an outdated study from the 60s, believe it or not, that has been interpreted incorrectly. These studies use non-stabilized versions of vitamin C and niacinamide, whereas of course we don't use unstabilized versions of these ingredients in skincare at all. That's not how it works. In fact, they use this nicotinic acid. This is like a byproduct of niacinamide, a horrible one. And pure vitamin C, not the ascorbic or L-ascorbic acid that we use usually in our serums or our vitamin C products. So they use two versions of the ingredients that we don't use in skincare, put them together in a hot room and warm temperatures, and they reacted badly together. But this is obviously, first of all, not how cosmetics will be formulated. It's also not reflective of how we store our cosmetics, the development, the manufacturing, or even how we use cosmetics as a consumer. So it's not relevant for cosmetics, if that makes sense. And my final one is using products targeted at your skin type. I'm speaking about this from an oily skin point of view, but I feel like it can apply to everyone. Browsing your local pharmacy, I think the products that really stand out amongst everything else is the spot care kind of products and the products targeted at oily skin. And these products are all mattifying, anti-shine, blotting, sebum control. All these products that sound ideal for oily skin and what I used to use in my teens and kind of into my early 20s, in fact. But these products are pretty counterintuitive because they're very, very temporary solutions. They're not solutions, they're not even fixes to oily skin. All that they do is make your skin look better on the outside for a bit, not helping the root cause of the situation or helping in the long run. They're just giving you that instant gratification and you think, oh, this product works, and you keep using it and buying more. So I actually saw the best improvement when I stopped using skincare targeted at my particular skin type. And that's because usually, in particular with oily skin, they're drying. And I found my skin would go crazy with this. So my skin would be dry, but also oily, producing a lot of oil. So when I stopped, all this changed. My skin was nice, it felt plump. My oil was better because I wasn't stripping my skin of oils. And in turn, my dark spots were going a lot quicker as well. Also, the idea of skin type is kind of like a good guide of what you should roughly be using on your skin. We're not just in those categories. Like, I'm oily, dry, and also sometimes dehydrated. So my skin can be everywhere. And I think skin type should only be used as a rough guide of what could work for your skin. And this shouldn't put you off using products that you think your skin's gonna enjoy. Like, I love hydrating moisturizers and hydrating toners as someone with oily skin. Obviously, don't go crazy. Like, if you have very, very dry skin, don't start using alcohol-heavy gel moisturizers or active ingredients that specifically say do not use on dry, damaged skin, you know? But just don't be afraid to use products that aren't typically associated for your skin type. It could completely change your skin. You never know. That's what happened with me. Let me know if you guys know anything else that could potentially be destroying your skin or even just ruining your skincare routine, what you've worked so hard for. As always, my videos are a discussion, so please let's discuss in the comments down below. Check out the playlist on the side here full of more skincare tips and tricks. And also the video underneath recommended just for you. But that's it for me now, guys. I will see you next time.